A joint press conference was called by the People's Democratic Alliance PDA and the Naga People's Front NPF Legislature Party on Naga political issue on Thursday. Leaders of ruling PDA led by Chief Minister Nipi Rio and opposition Naga People's Front NPF led by its leader T.R. Zeliang addressed a joint press conference. Addressing the press conference, State Chief Minister Nipi Rio clarified that the joint press conference was necessitated only because Union Home Minister Amit Shah had advised both ruling and opposition to do so and also to endorse the October 15 resolution. On NPF's proposal to form a parliamentary working committee, Rio said JLF also has MLAs as members besides the MPs and so no reason for changing JLF nomenclature. On the October 15 resolution, Rio said though the consultative meeting on October 15 was attended by many organizations and groups where all of them had given different opinions, yet the resolution drafted was accepted and adopted unanimously. On NPF's proposal to replace Speaker as JLF convener, Rio said it would mean disrespect to the Speaker's chair since the incumbent was a highly qualified professional and has been discharging his duties diligently without any mistake to warrant the change. Rio instead appealed to NPF to rejoin JLF since it was not possible nor easy to abandon the existing forum to form another platform.
Our Naga political issue is one Naga, one issue, one Naga. Therefore, rightly pointed out by the opposition leader that it should be inclusive. Solutions should be inclusive and one solution. That is what exactly Union Home Minister told us.
NPF leader T.R. Zeliang said at a time when the central government was seriously working to resolve the protracted Naga political issue, NPF would fully cooperate and work together with the state government on a common platform if it showed seriousness. With this in mind, Zeliang said he wrote to Rio on November 2 requesting him to consider the proposal of NPF Legislature Party at its recent meeting with elected members and NPF Party Working Committee on forming a new forum. Zeliang said a newly constituted and proposed all-party forum with the Chief Minister as head and a working committee in place would improve coordination and lessen complexities which the JLF faces.
During the course of our consultation and our mission, we got the sense that all Nagas desire one solution, one accord, which will ensure permanent peace in our land. And for this to materialize, the two negotiating groups should come to a mutual understanding and sign one accord on final day.
By polls to the two assembly constituencies, 14 Southern Angami 1 and 60 Pongro Kifri passed off peacefully barring stray incident on Tuesday amidst tight security and following COVID protocols. Around 88.1% of the total 43,242 voters exercised their franchise in the by-election to the two assembly seats, Chief Electoral Officer CEO Abhijit Sinha said. Polling was held at 22 polling stations under 14 Southern Angami constituency, which recorded 84.41% voting, while 77 polling stations under 60 Pongro Kifri registered 89.80% polling. Counting of votes will be taken up on November 10. Addressing media persons in the evening, Sinha said voting began at 6 a.m. and ended at 4 p.m. Webcast and static video recordings were done in all the polling booths to ensure free and fair elections, the CEO said. Sinha said that the entire polling process was by and large peaceful without any major untoward incident except at number 11 Singrap polling station under 60 Pongro Kifri constituency, where polling was adjourned during the first hour following a scuffle outside the polling booth. He said following the official complaint from the returning officer, a report was sent to the Election Commission of India from whom a re-poll directive was awaited. NDPP PDA consensus candidate Medo Yoka, NPF's Kikovi Karha and independent candidate Sewile Peter Jashumo contested for the 14th Southern Angami 1 seat. In the five-cornered contest for the bipole to 60 Pongro Kifri, BJP's Lirimong Sangtang, Kasio Anar of the Congress and independent candidates K. Shelumthong, T. Yangsio Sangtam and Kisimyu Yumchunger were in the fray. Nagaland Governor R.N. Ravi conferred the unit citation and unit appreciation to Assam Rifles units and Territorial Army Battalion at an investiture ceremony held at Raj Bhavan on Tuesday. Addressing the gathering, the governor lauded Assam Rifles for being the sentinel of the Northeast people. He said Assam Rifles, which is the oldest paramilitary forces in the country, also defended Kohima from Japanese invasion during World War II.
This appreciation and citation is well earned. Assam Rifles have been doing a human service to the people of Northeast India and also carrying out their responsibility in an outstanding manner wherever they have gone. In the rest of the country or even beyond.
Earlier, Major Sartaj Singh briefly highlighted about Assam Rifles and its role in Nagaland and the Northeast and unit brief of the recipient units. The vote of thanks was delivered by Major General VPS Kaushik, Inspector General Assam Rifles North. The Nagaland Master Printers Association NNPA on Friday held its general meeting cum felicitation of one of its members, Vihu Meyase, for being elected as Vice President East Zone All India Federation of Master Printers AIFMP. Addressing the function held at AMK Building, NNPA President Messi Zoko Zinye said that during the initial years there was no printers association. However, in the 70s, the printing press in Kohima came together and started the association under the name and style of Nagaland Printing Press Association. As far as printing technology is concerned, he said, we are still many years behind the others in India. He said that technology is developing at a rapid pace and changing many established methods. The print and design industries are excellent example of areas seeing these changes and innovations. In order to remain competitive and profitable, we have to keep pace with the fast-developing scenario, Zinir said, and opined that both the large and small printing houses should get themselves and updated on the latest developments in their industries, particularly in software and machines. He said that AIFMP is the apex body of Indian printers, which represents more than 2,50,000 printing companies. AIFMP is the world's largest printers association, he added. Also speaking at the function, Vihu Meyase hoped that NMPA would remain steadfast in unison and good coordination together to assist, encourage and give him directions as he take up this new responsibility. Earlier, the function was chaired by NMPA Vice President Zevenyu Yalitsu, while vote of thanks was proposed by NMPA Vice President Provotso Lohe. The members of the Nagaland Piano Teachers Association NPTA Kohima chapter gathered at the Music Academy Kohima and shared ideas and opinions on the need to push forward the discipline of piano in Nagaland on Wednesday. Addressing the members' task force for music and arts, TAFMA advisor Teja Meru said, "A dream that we dream alone is just a dream. A dream that we dream together is a reality." In this, he urged the members to come in unison to promote piano together. He assured that TAFMA would be pleased to collaborate with the NPTA in their efforts to promote piano in the state. He recalled that music leaders like Dr. Margaret Shikshak, Dr. Vive Peseye, and more have laid a solid music foundation for many. Meru also challenged the piano teachers to make Nagaland the piano capital of the country. He encouraged the younger lot to have vision and believe that it can be done.
So I want to say the sky is the limit. And like John Lennon said, a dream that we dream alone is just a dream. But a dream that we dream together is reality. And you know, if this is a singular dream, it's impossible. But if the 21 of us or the 30 of us here in this room dream together of creating such a wonderful ecosystem and leading the whole country in this piano field, if we dream together and work towards it, I think it's absolutely within our reach and a possibility. I want to share those with you.
Earlier NPTA President Kyochano TCK, NPTA Honorary Member Nise Meruno and Board Member Sahu Piesie joined Let's Talk About Piano session, which was moderated by Rokopeno Chase. Various churches across the state celebrated November 1, the first Sunday of the month, as World Sunday School Day with special services and activities. Union Christian Revival Church, New Market, Kohima, Sunday School children at UCRC New Market marked the day with various activities. Assistant Pastor UCRC Vera Say explained that the Sunday School movement began in Britain in the 1780s during the Industrial Revolution. During this period, many children spent all week long working in factories. Moreover, Saturday was part of the regular work week. Sunday, therefore, was the only available time for these children to gain some education. He told that English Anglican evangelist Robert Rikes was the key promoter of the movement. He said it soon spread to America as well. Denominations and non-denominational organizations caught the vision and energetically began to create Sunday schools. Within decades, the movement had become extremely popular, and gradually in the mid-19th century, Sunday school attendance was a near universal aspect of childhood. The Sunday school day was marked by presenting songs, skits, choreography, dances, Bible verse recitations, etc.
Thank you.